So my name is Nicholas Blanchet. I'm 31 years old. I currently live in San Francisco, California, though I have lived all over the United States, and I am have been diagnosed with bipolar 2 disorder. Bipolar 2 disorder is characterized by long periods of depression-like symptoms. So lethargy, lack of motivation, lack of ambition, periods of hopelessness, periods of sadness, although not everyone experiences it in the same way. In addition to that, bipolar 2 has a fun little twist where you've also got periods of what's called hypomania. Hypomania is like a less extreme form of mania. Mania being where you have a complete break from reality and you are hyper energetic, hyper optimistic. You usually take a lot of risky behavior. For example, sort of the characteristic that my doctor always tells me to watch out for is, give me a call if you've decided that you're going to Vegas and going to buy a yacht for the weekend, because it might seem like a lot of fun, so bring me in on the fun. Hypomania, in my case, manifested as periods of extreme sociability, hypersexuality, extreme productivity at work, and less sleep than normal. Also with bipolar 2 disorder, the hypomanic periods are rare, so 1 to 2 times a year, and fairly brief, somewhere between 3 and 7 days, which is very different than standard mania.
I see, and when were you diagnosed?
I was diagnosed bipolar 2 disorder in November of 2012.
Okay, so you've only known then for a little bit of time.
Right.
And how's that affected you? How did that come about?
So I had been diagnosed with depression and this is apparently, by the way, a very typical story. I had been diagnosed with depression for about 5 years. I was going to a psychiatrist and a psychologist regularly, and they would prescribe various antidepressants, none of which would work. And in fact, my symptoms over time gradually but noticeably trended worse and worse and worse. After I moved to the Bay Area, my psychiatrist that I got out here pointed out that I might actually not be responding well to the medication because it was treating something that I didn't have. And instead, he suggested that I switch to mood stabilizers. Well, the confirming fact came after I was taking a very high dosage of an antidepressant, and through the end of November and through most of December, I had a very, very bad period of depression. I had no motivation to do anything. I stopped going to work. It was pretty bad. And then when I went back in and saw him again, he prescribed what's called a mood stabilizer, which is different than an antidepressant.
Well, that leads me to another question about sort of advantages and disadvantages here. You've touched on them briefly, but from your own perspective, I mean, are there any advantages to being showing symptoms of bipolar, and I'm also curious in the disadvantages.
So the advantages, I've never really thought of it that way. One thing they don't tell you is that hypomania is awesome. It feels really good. You're an animal in bed. You are hyper-productive at work. You have a lot of energy. You are really social. You're really charming. You're really dynamic. You can be a little bit more risky with your behavior, but not so much so that people around you are like scared for you. So people just think, wow, Nick's really on par this weekend. You basically feel like you are king of the world for a period of time. The disadvantages are obviously work disruption, right? So that's the biggest one. With me, these long, drawn-out periods of silence. And you know, as a friend of mine, like I would go through periods where no one would hear from Nick. Where's Nick? I would just disappear, because keeping up appearances and making sure the people around me are comfortable and having a good time is important to me. And so when I was in a bad place, I, instead of like being the negative guy around everyone all the time, I just sort of removed myself from the situation. And of course, there's social stigma and stuff attached with it too, which makes it complicated. It makes it difficult to have relationships. It makes it difficult to stick to tasks. I stopped and started college a number of times, and looking back, it probably had a lot to do with this. Mm-hmm. I don't want to blame this for all of my problems, right? I still have good days and bad days. I'm still mortal. I still make mistakes. But I suppose now that I think about it, another advantage of bipolar disorder and having had it diagnosed is I get insight. I know a little bit more about why things happen. Why am I this way? Why? It gives context. It doesn't excuse things. I still have things I need to work on. But it gives a little context about what my struggles might be, about the things that I need to watch out for. It also makes sure that I exercise, because that's very helpful.
How do other people perceive you as someone who is bipolar? What's the general reaction? How is it perceived by others, both strangers, just say the general public, but also your friends? Have they responded? And what's your reaction to their reactions?
When people who I know and have known for a period of time find out that I'm bipolar, I tend to get one of two reactions. One is generally supportive and saying, oh, well, I'm glad you're just getting this managed. I'm glad you've got some stuff. And the other one sort of like a, duh, I could have told you that. Not because it manifested, because they have noticed these trends that I have. And they knew that there was something up, but they never knew what it was. Mm-hmm. And so, okay, this makes sense that you've got this.
We're curious in knowing, what is your family history of bipolar and any other mental health condition that you think might be related?
So my mom was diagnosed with bipolar 2 disorder, and she was actually on the same medication that I am on now for a while, but she never told me this. My sister, one of my younger sisters, suffers from depression. My dad is actually, on that side of the family, he is the most ADD person I have ever met in my entire life. Like, you know, the Wikipedia hole where you just clicking on hyperlink after hyperlink after hyperlink until you've got a million tabs open. Yeah, like, he can't use Wikipedia because it's paralyzing. His weekend will be gone.
What do you think about the portrayal of mental health in general, both in the media and in society at large, how we deal with it as a population? Do you think we take mental health seriously? Do you think it's portrayed in a meaningful way that gets the right kind of attention? Or do you think we still have some work to do?
I definitely believe that in the area of portrayal of mental health, in the area of how the average person thinks of mental health, we have some work to do, because It's easy to look at someone and say, you have a broken leg, you have a scratch, you've been burned. But when it permeates the mind, when it permeates the thing that's sitting behind the eyes and looking back at you, it's hard to say, well, you're an asshole, versus you have an issue. And because it's so difficult to recognize in the first place, we tend to overlook it, minimize it, and not give it the type of treatment that we should. If I had to have a message for somebody who's bipolar 2, I would definitely say seek medical assistance. This is something that responds very well to treatment. And once you've gotten the proper treatment, once you've been able to help yourself out, then you can live a very, very satisfying and happy life.